Hey there everyone, Hitesh here back again with another video. In this video, I want to give you three basic and important tips to become a better programmer. Now, these are not the tips made by myself. These are the tips that I have picked up from the discussion section. So recently, I took a deep look on my website as well as on the other platform where I teach, and I tried to figure out what are the common problems that every programmer as a beginner are facing, and I just wanted to deal up with a single video to all of those users. So in this video, I want to just target the beginners of programmers so that they can improve their debugging skills and show you some of the common things that they are missing. And also with that, I would like to mention that this video is totally for beginners. Beginners like people who are learning to install the things, making sure that their first Hello World run properly and all those things. This is not a video for the people who are kind of expert in making loops, function, or even just to design a simple smallest application. Those people are gonna think that this video is a time waste, so I just want to mention it very clearly at the first that hey, this video is not for you. This video is totally for the beginners. And with this, let's start with our three important tips for the beginners. Now, what the issue is that a lot of people who are beginner in the programming thinks that, hey, if somebody can tell us those most basic things so that we can improve our skills. And on the other hand, the professionals are thinking, hey, this is too much of the basic. We don't need to tell you this. And this creates a little bit gap, which is being in the beginners and the professionals. And I'm trying to just fill up this gap. With this, my first and foremost important tip is read the errors. Now, a lot of you might be thinking, hey, this is too much basic. We don't want to listen to this, but listen to me here. I have seen in a lot of discussion section and Q&A section where there is an error and the solution of that error is also in the screenshot or whatever they have posted, and still they are not just reading it. There are hundreds of examples. I'm just picking up one here. In this screenshot, you can see that the person is saying, I'm facing some error and I don't know how to solve that. Now, if you'll just read that particular message line by line, you'll be able to solve that automatically. Now, in this case, the error is saying that the VTX is not enabled in your BIOS setting. In case you don't know what the BIOS setting is, it's just the first black screen that opens up on your laptop where it says press F1 or press escape and something like that. So in that mode, your BIOS setting, your VTX or your virtualization is disabled. And the error is clearly mentioning it that you have to enable that, and that's it. Now, I'm not saying this is the only error that everybody is facing. There are a lot of such errors in which the solution is also mentioned, and what you are not doing is not reading the errors properly. The most important task of a programmer is not to just always see what is being built up or how the things finally cooked up is looking like. The most important part of a programmer is to struggle, is to read the errors. And there are hundreds of other errors. Recently, one student posted in the discussion section that, hey, I'm not able to run this command, sudo npm install some command. And I said, on which operating system you are? And he says, he posted a screenshot that, hey, this is the error. And obviously the error was simply he was on a Windows system, and in Windows system, the sudo is not being run. Now, I have just picked up these two examples, but there are hundreds of other examples where these kinds of errors show their solution in itself there as well. So all I'm trying to say is read the errors, especially when you're running any command on the terminal. I know at first the terminal is kind of a very scary thing for everybody, but try to understand this. Your number one job is to read the errors. Without reading the error, you cannot solve that. And most of the errors, I don't say every error, but most of the errors actually shows you what the problem is and how you can solve that. So make sure you read everything which is displayed on the screen. Tip number two that I want to give you is explore more options. Now, this is again a very common trait in programming courses and books and everything, that whenever a user is trying to just replicate the things what is being mentioned in the videos, they just like to do exactly same. It's okay for the first few minutes, but it doesn't always work out. Let me explain it in a more. For example, if I'm using a Python 3.2 maybe version in my videos, and obviously when you will be watching the videos, it will be like 3.5 or 3.6. So always and always try to use the latest version of the software. Regardless if it is a Python, if it is a Java, and if it is some softwares like your Bracket or anything like that. And with this, also I would like to add here is that sometimes what I'm mentioning might be good at that time, but future things might have changed. For example, let's put it into some example scenario. When I was designing my complete front-end development course, Bracket was the best thing I could have found out. Now, obviously, in that part, I have mentioned that there are hundreds of other editors, like Sublime Text is there, Bracket is there, Atom is there, and you have to explore your own options. And after that, after releasing that course, the Bracket team, the Adobe team, stopped working on the brackets, and the more frequent updates got stopped. So this means now Bracket is, it's still a very good editor, but still not that much up to date that I was expecting it to be in the future. But now I always recommend to explore more of your options. For example, I would highly recommend to check out Sublime Text, to check out Atom. And this is not the end of the world if one editor is not working for you. Explore more options. If you are learning Java, explore like Eclipse, explore NetBeans or IntelliJ, and figure out by yourself that which editor is suitable for your need and which one you are feeling that, hey, this one is made for me. This exploring of the software will not give you only the best software for your need, will also give you more idea about more of the blogs that you should be reading up, or more of the Stack Overflow Q&A section which you should be reading up. Obviously, everybody has its own preference, but still, exploring is the number one thing that every beginners in the programming should be doing up. Third, and the last, and the most important tip is the updates. I have seen a lot of computers and a lot of students' computer where their system is not up to date. Now, my request to all of you is to focus a lot on updates. Now, I do agree here that sometimes I even don't get time to update my Atom to the latest version or their plugins to the latest version. That's okay and that's fine. As soon as you get time, make sure you do hit the update there. Most of the software version that I use in my videos and my daily life are open source, and there is no such big problem to update them. As soon as you get time, the first thing that you should be doing is update. With this, the bigger problem comes up when your operating system is out of date. Now, sometimes I have seen in the bootcamp that the person who is using a Macintosh hasn't updated their operating system to the latest one. The first thing I recommend to them is make sure, go ahead, do the update, because the software that we're using, like let's just say the Xcode or Android Studio, whatever we are using, is compatible to your latest operating system, not the backward one, the latest one. So you may face a lot of problems that might have no solution. It's a big problem. So make sure you get your system up to date. And obviously the more problem comes up when I see a lot of pirated operating system. Now, I would recommend that if you are spending a budget of, let's just say, 50,000, make sure out of that 50,000, your budget also includes your operating system. And with this, I am targeting Windows here, because a lot of people see that, hey, I'm gonna just buy a DOS-based computer or a laptop and I'll just install a pirated Windows. This might work, but I don't recommend it because it generates a lot of problems. Even I have seen that people are still using like Windows 7, and obviously that Windows 7 is also pirated, so neither they are getting updates, and also the softwares that they are trying to use, like Android Studio or anything like that, is not compatible to that. And obviously you have bought and you have spent and invested some money in buying the hardware, so you should also be investing some money in getting the actual and original version of the operating system. So make sure your budget includes the Windows as well. Being on the outdated operating system, especially on the Windows, may lead a lot of problems, not just about the Windows compatibility with your latest Android Studio or your editor or whatever the software you're using, but also you are prone to the latest attacks like the WannaCry and all these attacks that are keep getting on. The number one reason of them is people are not getting updated frequently. So Windows is trying hard to push all those updates, and since you are on the pirated copy, you are not getting that updates. It's not a good thing, so make sure you buy that. I do understand that with the third tip, a lot of people are gonna just rant that, hey, we cannot buy that, we don't have money to buy that. If you don't have money to buy that, obviously you should not be using that, you should leave that. Go on, switch on to Linux like Ubuntu or Fedora. There are a lot of other great operating systems that you can try up. But again, with those operating systems, their own problems comes up, like the compatibility issues and all these things. If you're ready to deal up with that, It's completely okay. But I would say if you don't have a budget of buying a Windows, you should not be using it. So these are my three tips that I have explored recently on all the discussion section and Q&A section on all the platform that I teach. And from wherever the instructor is, from whoever you are learning, it doesn't really matter. Just keep on learning and make sure you follow all these three steps in whatever the course you are enrolled in or whoever the instructor is. These are applicable for everybody and every course. With this, I would say, if you're new onto this channel, make sure you do hit that subscribe button. I regularly post these kinds of useful videos, as well as sometimes we make some awesome applications on websites, on Android, on iOS, and a lot of things happen on this channel, everything related to programming and tech. So again, if you are new, do hit that subscribe button. And if you have enjoyed this video, do hit that like button, and I'll surely catch you up in the next video.